Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture. In this lecture, I have a topic, Interactive Online Teaching. So due to the pandemic situation, we are forced to teach online. And in online teaching, we have two semesters of experience. And this is going to be the third semester in online teaching. We have varied experience in the online teaching. We faced a lot of troubles from the students, troubles from the technology, and we have our own difficulties in conducting classes online. And based on the experience, many teachers learnt a lot through online teaching. Maybe in the pedagogy, teaching pedagogy, we learnt a lot through online. But still, we have something in our mind about the students' behavior, either technically, subject-wise, behavioral. We have many complaints, concern about the students' behavior in the online classes. So I have certain points. They are not listening to the teachers. This is a common complaint from all the majority of the teachers. They are on the line, but we do not know whether they are listening to the teacher. Because whenever we call the students by name, they are not responding. So even they are responding, if you ask the question, so they will tell, immediately they will give an answer. Sir, we have some network problem, we are in the rural place, something like that. So, the listening to the teacher, listening to the lecture, it is a big question. And irregular to the class because of many reasons. They are preoccupied with their work, with the family work. They have insufficient data, network problem, all these things. And again, few students in rural area, they have their own trouble from the family earning. So they are going for jobs. As a labor, they are going. So they are irregular to the class. Not connected continuously because of the network. The data connection, remote place or availability of data, they are not connected continuously even for a single class. So if you monitor the presence of the students, they will disconnected and then once again they are joining again. So this is, they are not connected continuously, preoccupied by the work, family work, or they are going for some part-time job for earning. So they are irregular to the class. Using more social media. This is the common complaint nowadays. But through social media only, we have to talk to the students today. We have to teach the students. So, we have to use these two social media effectively. They are using more social media, all right. But we have to use the social media for our better teaching. And running short of internet data. So, this is one complaint. So, some students are telling that, so today only I am going to recharge my data connection. So they are running short of money. They are not caring for studies because of the various reasons. So even if they complete with a higher mark or higher percentage, due to lack of skill in the subject. Skill in the behavior, behavioral skill, it is very difficult to get a job nowadays. So they have their attitude, careless attitude towards their studies. They're not preparing for the test academically. When you conduct some test, weekly test or the monthly test for assessment purpose, for internal mark purpose, they're not preparing. They're not preparing well and present the test. And not genuine in preparation of assignment. So when you give monthly assignment, many teachers complain that there are only few students very few students, they are preparing the assignment. All the other people, they are copying. Sometimes the name of the student is also copied without writing the student name. They are writing the friend's name. These are all the some of the complaints. So we have many such a complaint. We stop here. So it is enough. Now, in spite of all the trouble, then how to make the teaching and learning more effective and interactive in online mode? That is the question in front of us. How we are going to conduct the online classes effectively for one more semester at least. So for that, we have to understand the paradigm for teaching. So what is the mission and purpose, criteria for success, teaching and learning structure, nature of role and teaching assumption. So these are all these are 5 points I have taken for discussion. If you Google it, Google the topic, particularly new paradigm for teaching, you may find some 20-30 points. So I have taken some important 5 points for your, I want to take the 5 points to your knowledge. First, the mission and purpose. So the old paradigm, so 5 years back or 10 years back, what was the methodology in teaching is improving quality of instruction. So we have to improve the quality of instruction, how we are instructing, how we are doing, how we are conducting the class, that is the objective. But today, the mission and purpose is improving quality of learning. So the quality of learning, how we are going to improve the quality of learning of the students, that is the question. That is the question for the future also, using the NEP. This is the question. The new paradigm is based on the NEP. So criteria for success. Earlier, good quality students, quality of entering students was the criteria for success. So that was true in earlier 20 years, 30 years back. The number of engineering colleges were small in number, small. So less number of engineering colleges, less than 200 or 250. Nowadays 500 plus engineering colleges. So the quality of entering students is a big question. So that is not working today. So the criteria for success for today, it is quality of exiting students. So how skillful students we are delivering, how skillful students are leaving, graduating from the institution. That is the new paradigm for teaching. And teaching learning structure. So in the earlier style, paradigm, old paradigm, covering the learning material, covering the syllabus was the focus. But here, today, specific learning objective, learning outcome, it is the focus. So what the student learn at the end of the lecture, what the student learn at the end of the course, what the student learn at the end of the 4 years, that is what the focus. So the specific learning outcome based education, a result oriented learning. So that is what the today new paradigm. The nature of role, faculty being primarily lecturers in the earlier old paradigm. But today, they are not just lecturing, they have to create the faculty being designer of learning method and environment. So this we have to understand what is designing of learning method or instructional design. That also nowadays the teachers, they have to search and they have to change their instructional design. Not just taking notes, referring to the different textbook, standard books and then delivering in the lecture. That is not working today. And teaching assumption, in the old paradigm, any expert on the subject can teach. But today, teaching is a complex phenomena and require considerable training, particularly on the pedagogical technique. So in the new paradigm, it is what the future of teaching. Any institution, either the school education or higher education, this is the new paradigm is going to be the future. So we have to improve, we have to focus on all the 5 points, the 5 main points of the paradigm for new paradigm for teaching. And in nutshell, every lecture is to be carefully designed. So there is a triangle of effective learning. So wherever I go, I just to focus on this point, I am imparting this concept to the teachers, young teachers. So every lecture is to be designed for a particular outcome. It is not course outcome, it is learning outcome, or even you can call it as lecture outcome for a particular lecture. When you prepare for 50 minutes, at the end of the 50 minutes, what the student will do? That is what the learning outcome. That is what we have to focus today. So, and again, so to achieve the learning outcome, how we are going to design our teaching learning activity. So, the design of teaching, it is not just lecturing. Going inside the classroom and lecturing will not work today online or offline. So, teaching learning activity, and immediately at the end of every lecture, we have to assess the lecture, assess the outcome, and you have to give the feedback. So, this triangle we have to understand for the teaching, the people in teaching of engineering, any education institution, you have to understand this triangle, and you try to reorient your lecturing style or lecture preparation according to this triangle. And nowadays, online teaching, we are all familiar with all the tool here, YouTube, NPTEL videos, Zoom meeting, Google meeting, Google Classroom, Google Form, Microsoft Teams, some colleges they are using Microsoft Teams, Canvas Instructor, the LMS, Google Jamboard and PowerPoint presentation. So, all these tools we learnt because of the pandemic situation for online teaching, we learnt all these things. In addition, there are many such a thing, Coursera, the online video lectures are available on YouTube, lectures available. So, there are many tools available for our help, for our usage. Now, the methodology what I have practiced in the previous semester. So, first semester, it's all right. Second semester, I readjusted my teaching methodology to make the online teaching more interactive. So, I am going to present it. So, lecture notes, we have to prepare. Lecture notes, it is not lecture notes, instructional notes, we have to prepare, and using the Google Classroom, we have to share to the students. So, if you have licensed version of the G Suite, Google Suite, it is well and good. Your work will be very simple. You can do many monitoring mechanisms are available. There are many extension links. You can use it effectively. But if you are not a licensed version, if you do not have a licensed version, but still we can use the Google Classroom for sharing your notes. Or any LMS, we can use the Canvas Instructor or Microsoft Teams also for sharing the notes. So, the notes, lecture notes have to be shared before we conduct the class and the presentation using the PPT. So, that is only methodology. You have to prepare PPT or using the Jamboard we have to teach. Then sharing video lecture. So, this is the order of the day. Because many students, so the students, they have many problems. They have the network problem. They are not continuous. They are not effectively listening to the class. So, for such a student, sometimes they are preoccupied, going for some job. So, for such a students, if you share the video lecture of your presentation. So, I have almost 400 video lectures for my subjects. I share the video lectures for every lecture. So, if you have such a video lecture, it is well and good. Otherwise, you can use the NPTEL video or YouTube video to supplement your PPT presentation. So, share the video lectures. So, again, by listening to a lecture for a single time, many students, they may not understand the subject. If they listen to many, 2-3 times, they can understand the concept. So, sharing video lecture is important. If you do not have your own prepared video lectures, you can download, you can get the link from YouTube or NPTEL, you can share to the students. And daily attendance and assessment using the Google form. This is very, very important, right? So, the presentation, using your PPT presentation, normally for a 50 minutes period, you may have some 10 PPTs, 10 PowerPoint presentation, 10 slides. So, from the 10 slides, you have to ask 5 questions or 10 questions, MCQ, multiple choice questions. And that questions are to be used as a assessment tool for the presentation. This is the assessment of particular lecture. Then you may have the weekly assignment using the Google Classroom. We can give the weekly assignment using the Google Classroom. So, what is the use of this attendance? For attendance purpose, you can use the Google form, and assessment purpose also you can use the Google form. The result, the response of the students in the Google form for the assessment of the lecture, it should be discussed in the next class. In the next class, first 5 minutes, you have to open the Google form and discuss the answers so that the students may understand their success rate. Some students would have scored 5 marks, 10 out of 10, or some students failed to get some normal score. So all these right answers, their performance should be shared with the students. That will be the motivation for the students to perform better in the succeeding Google Form test. And particularly the PPT presentation, how to make the 15 minutes presentation more useful way. So for that, you can use this model. So first 5 minutes, you can have some discussion of the previous test. Then we can have a presentation for 15 minutes. Out of the 15 minutes, so maybe 5 slides or 6 slides. So using the 6 slides, you can have a reflection quiz. Maybe 2 questions, MCQ questions. So you can ask from the previous 6 slides. So that is a break. So remember, students cannot continue, anybody, any natural tendency today, the human being, they cannot continuously listen to a lecture for more than 15 minutes. Even if you take your own experience, if you listen to a YouTube video, if it is more than 15 minutes, so what do? You skip, either you skip or you can simply pass it and take only glimpses of the video lecture. So 15 minutes is the normal time for the anybody to listen to any presentation or the lecture. So immediately after 15 minutes, you have some activity. So online, what we can do, you can have a reflection quiz. So you can have a question in the PPT. You can open the discussion and ask the student to answer the question. Similarly, you can have another 15 minutes presentation, and last 5 minutes again you have the reflection quiz. So this model you can follow so that you can make the presentation useful and the presentation interactive with the students. So this model, what I have practiced in the previous semester, I am more strengthening, I am more very, very effectively redesigning my lecture once again, so that it will be more useful and interactive for the students. So thank you for watching. Please post your comments on the comments box. If you have any queries, if you want any further help, you can contact me through my mail ID or WhatsApp number. So we'll meet again with another lecture in the instruction or pedagogical technique. Until then, bye.